Welcome to my channel once again. Now we are going to discuss a topic called axial flow compressors. Axial flow compressors usually consist of a series of stages, each stage comprised of row of rotor blades followed by row of stator blades. The working fluid is initially accelerated by rotor blades and then decelerated in the stator passage. In the stator, the kinetic energy transferred into the rotor is converted to static pressure. This process is repeated in several stages to yield necessary overall pressure ratio. The compression process consists of a series of diffusion. This occurs both in the rotor as well as the stator. Due to motion of rotor blades, two distinctive velocity components, that is absolute and relative velocities in the rotor blades, are developed. The absolute velocity of a fluid is increased in the rotor, whereas the relative velocity is decreased, leading to diffusion. Per stage pressure ratio is limited because a compressor operates in an adverse pressure gradient environment. Turbines, on the other hand, operate under favorable pressure gradients. Several stages of an axial compressor can be driven by single turbine stage. Careful design of the compressor blading is essential to minimize losses as well as to ensure stable operation. Some compressors also have inlet guidance vanes, that is IGV, that permit the flow entering the first stage to vary under off design conditions. Velocity triangles. Elementary analysis of axial compressor begins with velocity triangles. The analysis will be carried out at the mean height of the blade, where the peripheral velocity and blade speed is U. The absolute component of velocity will be denoted by C and the relative component velocity V. Here, three velocity components we can see, that is, velocity or the blade speed is represented by U, and velocity will be, that is, absolute velocity will be represented by C, and the relative velocity will be represented by V. The axial velocity of absolute velocity will be denoted by CA, that is, axial component of absolute velocity is represented by CA, and the tangential component will be denoted by the subscript W, example CW, that is, tangential component of absolute velocity is CW, whereas VW is relative velocity component of relative tangential velocity component of, okay. Then alpha denotes the angle between absolute velocity with the axial direction, and beta corresponds to the angle of relative velocity. So here we can see absolute velocity is equal to the relative velocity plus blade velocity. We can state it as, initially here we can see a rotor and a stator. This complete assembly, that is from stage 1 to stage 3, we'll calling it as a single stage. So a rotor followed by a stator will be considered as single stage in compressor. Similarly, in turbines, we'll be having stators at first and then rotors next. There will be considering that one as a single stage. In order to drive several number of stages of the compressor, one stage of turbine is enough. So here we can see, as we have seen, that C represents absolute velocity, V represent relative velocity, and U represents blade speed. Similarly, upon combining these two, first, second and third stages, so here one represent initial stage before entering into the compressor before the rotor blade, two represents the stage, the velocity components of air molecules after leaving rotor, and three represents after leaving a stator blade. So here rule number 1, 2 and 3 represents velocity components of first one, second one and third one. Here you can see delta CW, that is tangential component of absolute velocity. Change in tangential component of absolute velocity can be drawn with these things. and axial component of velocity can be drawn like this. Okay, then moving further, here property changes across the stages, that is from 1, 2, 2, 2, 2, 3, how the stage properties are getting changed, we can see over here. Total enthalpy will increase from stage 1 to stage 2, whereas in stage 2 to 3, the enthalpy remains constant. Similarly, absolute velocity will increase from 1 to 2 and absolute velocity decreases from 2 to 3. Similarly, static pressure from point 1, that is stage 1 to 2, it will get increased. From stage 2 to 3 also it will get increased. Because of rotors, there will be compression process will be taking place, so that there will be an increase in pressure. Once the starter plates start, they will stabilize, they will try to reduce the velocity. So because of sudden static pressure, there will be an increase in much more static pressure in starter stage. Work and compression. Assuming CA is equal to CA1 is equal to CA2, that is axial component of absolute velocity in stage 1 and stage 2 are equal, if we consider in that manner, from the velocity triangles we can see that u by ca is equal to tan alpha 1 plus tan beta 1, and u by ca is equal to tan alpha 2 plus tan beta 2. By considering the change in angular momentum of the air passing through the rotor, work done per unit mass flow can be given as w is equal to u of cw2 minus cw1, where CW2 and CW1 are the tangential components of the fluid velocity after and before the rotor respectively. Work done and compression. The above equation can also be written as W is equal to UCA of tan alpha 2 minus tan alpha 1. Since tan alpha 2 minus tan alpha 1 is equal to tan beta 1 minus tan beta 2, work done can be given as UCA of tan beta 1 minus tan beta 2. In other words, W can be written as U delta CW. The input energy will reveal itself in the form of rise in stagnation temperature of the air. The work done as given above will also be equal to the change in the stagnation enthalpy across the stage. Work done and compression. H02 minus H01 is equal to U delta CW. Similarly, we can write T02 minus T01, that is change in temperature, can be given as U delta CW by CP. That implies we can write it as delta T0 by T01 can be written as U delta CW by CP T01. Since the flow is adiabatic and no work is done as the fluid passes through the starter, that implies we can write it as T03 is equal to T02. Let us define stage efficiency eta st, can be given as, that is stage efficiency is equal to H03S minus H01 divided by H03 minus H01. This can be expressed as T03S by T01 is equal to 1 plus stage efficiency into delta T0 by T01. The above equation delta T0 can be written as T03 minus T01. In terms of pressure ratio, we can rewrite it as P03 by P01 is equal to 1 plus stage efficiency multiplied by change in temperature divided by T01 whole power gamma by gamma minus 1. This can be combined with the earlier equation given, then we can write it as P03 by P01 as 1 plus stage efficiency U delta CW by CP T01 power gamma by gamma minus 1. From the above equation that relates the per stage temperature rise to the pressure ratio, it can be seen that to obtain a high temperature ratio for a given overall pressure ratio for minimizing number of stages, high blade speed limited by blade stresses, high axial velocity, high fluid deflection, that is angle beta 1 minus beta 2, aerodynamic considerations and adverse pressure gradient limit the above. Design parameters. The following design parameters are often used in the parametric study of axial flow compressor. One is flow coefficient, second one is stage loading, third one is degree of reaction, fourth one is diffusion factor. So here flow coefficient can be given as phi, which is Ca divided by U, and stage loading can be given as psi, that is delta H naught by U square, that can be written as delta Cw by U. Degree of reaction will be denoted by Rx and the diffusion factor given by D star. Degree of reaction, diffusion takes place in both the rotor and the stator. Static pressure rises in the rotor as well as the stator. Degree of reaction provides a measure of the extent to which the rotor contributes to the overall pressure rise in the stage. Degree of reaction can be given as the ratio of static enthalpy rise in the rotor blade to stagnation enthalpy rise in the stage. So static enthalpy rise in the rotor blade can be given as H2 minus H1, and the stagnation enthalpy rise in the stage can be given as H03 minus H01. This is almost similar to H2 minus H1 divided by H02 minus H01. For a nearly incompressible flow, H2 minus H1 can be given as 1 by rho of P2 minus P1 for the rotor, and for the stage H03 minus H01, it is almost nearly equal to 1 by rho of P03 minus P01. Rx, that it can be written as degree of reaction, can be rewritten as H2 minus H1 divided by H02 minus H01 as P2 minus P1 by P02 minus P01. From the steady flow energy equation, H1 plus V1 square by 2 plus is equal to, H2 plus V2 square by 2. That implies degree of reaction again can be rewritten as V1 square minus V2 square by 2 U of Cw2 minus Cw1. For constant axial velocity, V1 square minus V2 square is equal to Vw1 square minus Vw2 square. And Vw1 minus Vw2 can be given as Cw1 minus Cw2. On simplification, Rx can be given as 1 by 2 minus Ca by 2U of tan alpha 1 minus tan alpha tan beta 2. Or degree of reaction can be rewritten as Ca by 2U of tan beta 1 plus tan beta 2. Special cases of degree of reactions can be seen over here. When degree of reaction is equal to 0, that means beta 2 is equal to minus beta 1. There is no pressure rise in the rotor. The entire pressure rise is due to the stator. The rotor merely deflects the incoming flow, impulse blading. Rx is equal to 0.5 gives the velocity triangles are symmetric, equal pressure rise in the rotor and stator blades. Rx is equal to 1.0, that is degree of reaction is equal to 1, that means entire pressure rise is taking place in the rotor while the stator has no contribution. So here we can see the velocity triangles, how they will change. So here we can see degree of reaction as 0 in that case. Here we can see beta 1 is equal to minus beta 2. Similarly, here alpha 1 is equal to beta 2 and alpha 2 is equal to beta 3 because of degree of reaction is equal to 0.5, and we can see two similar triangles overlapping. Similarly, here in this we can see Rx is equal to 1.0. With this we can state that alpha 2 is equal to minus alpha 1. That means complete work is done by rotor blades, not by stators. Diffusion factor, fluid deflection, can be given as beta 2 minus beta 1 is an important parameter that affects the stage pressure rise. Excessive deflection, which means high rate of diffusion, will lead to blade stall. Diffusion factor is parameter that associates blade stall with deceleration on the suction surface of the airfoil section. Diffusion factor D star is defined as D star is equal to Vmax minus V2 by V1, where Vmax is the ideal surface velocity at the minimum pressure point and V2 is the ideal velocity at the trailing edge and V1 is the velocity at the leading edge. So here we can see Vmax, how it is, how we are going to take it as maximum velocity, and V1 and V2. And we can see pressure on surfaces with the help of these diagrams, and velocity to chord percentage. Here we have drawn a graph. Laveline in 1953 proposed an empirical parameter for a diffusion factor. It is expressed entirely in terms of known or measured quantities. It depends strongly upon solidity, that is C by S. It has been proven to be dependable indicator of approach to separation for a variety of blade shapes. D star is usually kept around 0.5. D star can be given as 1 minus V2 by V1 plus VW1 minus VW2 by 2 of C by S V1, where C is the chord of the blade and S is the spacing between the blades. With this, we'll be winding up the video. If you like the video, please do like, share and subscribe.